podcast. You are trapped in history with Mr. Malcolmson and Miss Basham. Today's episode is kind of just a tutorial, a walkthrough, basically of the idea of focal point. Okay, so we just had assignment one with the God Creating Adam painting. And while I was going through looking at it, it seemed like a lot of students were confused about what is a focal point? What does that mean? So I really wanted to share a short video. Let me see, I'm gonna share my screen about a focal point. So if you look over here on my share screen, you see the railroad tracks going off into the distance. All a focal point is whenever your eye is drawn to a certain location in a painting. So in this particular instance, the eye is drawn through here to this far direction in the horizon, okay, this far point here. Now, the way that the photographer does this is by using lines and motion and along with this circle here to really draw your eye right there. That's the first place your eye should go whenever you look at this. But lines aren't the only way that a painter or a photographer really can use focal point. So another example is through color. So if we go to the next picture, your eye should automatically go straight to the red apple. Okay, so the red apple sticks out. That is the part of the painting where my eye, boom, goes straight to the red. So that is an example. That is the focal point. In this situation, the artist, the photographer, uses color and motion to do this. So we have the lines all going towards this one point in the far horizon. And then this is the only point really that it stands out. It's a different color than what is surrounding it. So this should be where your eye goes. That is the focal point of this piece. Okay, so a couple of historical references really quickly. This isn't going to be a long video. You should recognize this from our little Ice Age assignment. The first place your eye typically will go is this midpoint right here. Okay, it's the middle of the painting, and that's a lot of times where the focal point is going to be, is in the middle. And it using color, it stands out from the rest of the gray, gloomy background. Now, this is a piece that some of you might recognize, especially being in the Bible Belt. This is The Last Supper. It is another piece from the Renaissance. We're going to talk about it in another video. But you can see here using lines, so the ceiling, the lines here on the walls, along with the background with the windows. And then if you look at the people, they are creating a line. And all of this points to the very center where Jesus is, okay? Jesus right here, he is the focal point. We've got all the lines pointing there. That is the first place your eye should go, all right? So let's go back to the God Creating Adam painting, all right? The very first place your eye is drawn to. Look at where all of the lines are pointing. Look at, like we said, typically the center of the painting or the photograph. Not always, but typically. All of the lines, the outstretched arms, the eye gazes, pointing to right here. Okay, so that is the focal point where their hands are almost touching. A lot of people said, you know, the focal point is God creating Adam. Okay, I think whenever you hear focal point, you thought that's the point of the painting. But no, the focal point is where your eye is drawn to. Now, there were a couple people who said the focal point in this painting is God. Because of the use of color and him being the only one clothed, my eye was drawn there. That is a reasonable answer. That is a logical answer. And you explained it. Okay, some people just put God. If you didn't explain to me, well, why God, then I probably took points off because you didn't tell me, well, my eye was drawn there. The different color or the fact that he was clothed made him stand out. Okay, focal point, I really want you to look for what stands out. What is my eye drawn to first? So in this painting, the answer I was really looking for was the hands. All right, so that is all that I have for you on this short video. Make sure you hit subscribe and the bell. That way, whenever I post short little tutorials like this or Mr. Malcolmson does, then you will, you know, be notified of that. Until next time, I hope you all have a great day and you are released.